वेलकम बैक टू अवर चैनल रेस्पेक्ट एजुकेशन। नाउ लेट अस सी नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, दैट इज क्वेश्चन नंबर 12। फाइंड द वैल्यूज ऑफ वाई फॉर विच द डिस्टेंस बिटवीन पी टू कॉमा माइनस थ्री एंड क्यू टेन कॉमा वाई is 10 units. The meaning is that distance between P and Q is 10 units. So we need to find the value of Y. So before starting this problem, let us write the distance formula. The distance between A x1 y1 and B x2 y2 is AB is under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the distance formula between the given two points. Now here given the distance between P and Q is 10 units. So let us write, given the distance between P 2 comma minus 3 and Q 10 comma Y is 10 units. That means it can be written as PQ is equal to 10 units. So PQ is equal to 10. Now let us do, on squaring both the sides, on squaring both the sides, PQ becomes PQ square, 10 becomes 10 square, means 100. When we do square, what happens? This square and this square root both get cancelled. So here directly we can write x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus 1 whole square. So here you see, let us label it as x1 y1 and this as x2 y2. X2 minus x1 means 10 minus 2 whole square. 10 minus 2 whole square plus y2 means here y. Y minus of minus 3. So y plus 3. So it is y plus 3 whole square is equal to 100. Right? Now let us simplify this. 10 minus 2 is 8. 8 square is 64. 64 plus y plus 3 whole square is equal to 100. Here, there are two methods to solve. We can expand y plus 3 whole square by using the formula a plus b whole square. Then we get a quadratic equation. On solving it, we will get y value. That is one way. And another way is there, that is the easiest way that I am going to say now here. Send 64 that side. Then what happens here? Y plus 3 whole square is left on. When 64 moves from left hand side to right hand side, it becomes plus 64 becomes minus 64. Already 100 is there this side, so it is 100 minus 64. 100 minus 64 is 36. So here let us continue here. Y plus 3 whole square equal to, y plus 3 whole square equal to 100 minus 64 is 36. 36 can be written as 6 square. So here we got y plus 3 whole square equal to 6 square. Right? Now on taking square roots both the sides, on taking square roots, then what happen? Root and 2 get cancelled. So here this side y plus 3 will come. Here when we take square root, what happens here? Plus or minus under root 6 square, that is 6. Is it clear? See, this side when we apply square root, here only y plus 3. This side when we apply square root, square and root get cancelled. So plus or minus 6. Either side, either this side or that side, we have to maintain plus or minus. Mostly we maintain right side. So here now this problem is split into two parts. What are those? First one is y plus 3 is first case plus 6. Y plus 3 is in second case minus 6. Plus or minus means one time plus 6, second time minus 6. That is the meaning. So here you send this plus 3 that side. Y equal to 6 minus 3. So y equal to 6 minus 3 is 3. This is one of the values of y. Let us find the other value. Send this plus 3 right side. Then here y is equal to already minus 6 is there. Let us write minus 6 as it is. Plus 3 becomes minus 3. So here y is minus 6 minus 3, minus 3 is minus 9. Right? Now here read the question. Find the values of y. Therefore we can write that y equal to either 3 or minus 9. These are the values for y. So with this, this problem 12th one gets completed. Now let us see next question, that is question number 13. Find the radius of the circle whose center is 3, 2 and passes through minus 5, 6. So let us see what is given and what is to be found. We need to find the radius of a circle. For example, let us take this as a circle whose center is given as, here the given center is 3, 2. So here this point is the center of the circle. Now here it passes through minus 5, 6. The circle passes through this minus 5, 6. So you can take this point on any part of the circumference of the circle. For example, here I am taking the point that is minus 5, 6. This point is minus 5, 6. See, you just compare the question whether it matches or not. We need to find the radius. Okay, anyway we are going to find it. Whose center is, see, center of the circle is 3, 2 and the circle passes through minus 5, 6. This minus 5, 6 you can take anywhere, no problem. Okay, it is not necessary that you have to take this side or here. It is not like that. You can take however it is possible for you. As per your convenience, you can take. But this point should lie on the circumference of the circle because the circle should pass through it. Right? Now here, let us join these two points. See here, if A3, 2 is the center, B-5, 6 is a point on the circumference of the circle, then the distance between A and B, see this point is A, this point is B, the distance between A and B, that is AB, that is nothing but the radius of the circle. Is it clear? So let us write here clearly. Given center of the circle, center of the circle is A 3, 2, right? And the circle passes through minus 5, 6. So let us write, it passes through B minus 5, 6. We need to find the radius. Now radius of the circle, we can say it as radius is nothing but the distance between center to any point on the circumference of the circle, that is nothing but B. So here we can write the distance between A, that is 3, 2, and B, that is minus 5, 6. So let us find the distance so that we will be able to find the radius. Right? As we know the distance between two points formula, the distance between the line, means the distance between the points AX1, Y1 and BX2, Y2 is nothing but under root x2 minus x1 whole square plus y2 minus y1 whole square. This is the formula for finding distance between two points. Now here these two are the points. Let us find the distance now. That is under root. This is x1, y1, x2, y2. X2 minus x1 means minus 5 minus 3 whole square. Minus 5 minus 3 whole square plus 6 minus 2 whole square. 6 minus 2 whole square. Right? Let us simplify. Minus 5 minus 3 is minus 8. Minus 8 whole square is 64. Or we can add this as plus 4 plus 8 whole square also. So let us write this value as 64 plus 6 minus 2 is 4. 4 square is 16. 4 square is 16. Now on adding, here I am continuing here. Right? So radius, I am denoting this with small r. This distance I am taking as small r. So now small r is equal to, it's a continuation here. 64 plus 16. Here this is 70, then 80. It is root 80. Right? So root 80 can be written as 16 times 5. When we got this product, we can split the square root. Root 16 into root 5. Root 16 nothing but 4. So it is 4 root 5. R is equal to 4 root 5 units. R equal to 4 root 5 units. R is nothing but the radius. So we can write that therefore radius of the circle is, radius of the circle is 4 root 5 units is the final answer for this problem, 13th one.